Computers, machines, the silicon dream. 70 retired from the scene, and he said, behold, what I have done. I made a better world for everyone. Nobody left, nobody cried.
That was a clip from Breaking Glass, a movie which launched our next guest star into superstardom. Here's Hazel O'Connor, here she is. Hazel, how did you ever get a part in that movie?
Accident, total accident.
What happened?
Working in a switchboard.
Yes.
Because I had no money. Record company didn't used to figure on giving me any money at the time.
You were spotted by the producer?
No, they just phoned up to talk about, because they had a list of singers and people that had been around the punk times in London. And
were you a punk?
Yes, at the time I was.
Really?
Not then, because punk had already finished by the time Breaking Glass was happening.
But right.
Fleet Street and the general newspapers made the mistake of calling it punk when punk had already become obsolete.
You were sort of a post-punk.
Post-punk, that's what we were actually trying to develop in that film. It was, that was a word.
Really?
Was
it?
Post-punk.
Oh, that's nice.
All the producers saying post-punk, you know, what the kids on the street think. No, the normal sort of patronising stuff.
That's great. I mean, that gear that you wore is amazing. Or the gear that you wore, was quite amazing. All lighting up and sort of weird. What was it you actually wearing there?
Actually, it was very simple stuff. It was the same stuff as Superman's mum and dad wore back on Krypton, you know, in the film. It was the same stuff, so he knows.
You know, dear. Yeah.
And it's called 3M. And actually, it's just very thin material with lots and lots of little mirror bits in
mirror
it.
Bits,
And when you have a camera shining on you, the camera light has to be very bright, and you don't have any other lights on at all, and then it just reflects straight on, like this.
That's marvellous.
It's like this, you know.
Listen, what are you up to?
Cosmic.
What are you up to at the moment? Are you doing anything exciting? Apart from sitting here?
Oh, well, it's here, isn't it?
Yeah. I mean, are you recording a new album and things?
I will be soon. I've just done an album's worth of stuff with Martin Rushent for a TV series called Jangles that's probably going to be coming out in April now.
Hang on. That's a funny noise. What's that?
I don't know. Was it me? Was it over there?
It's somebody over there.
Oh, no.
There's a heck of a thing. Listen, how on earth did you start doing judo? Because you're judo championed and all sorts, all around the world.
Well, I started about 24, 25 years ago, and it was my dad, really. I mean, he's a taxi driver, and he was frightened of getting mugged. So he started judo so he could defend himself and keep fit, and that was it.
And Hazel, sorry to ignore you, however briefly, but tell me, why do you do judo? How did you start?
Oh, I just liked it. I thought it was good fun, and I also liked our teacher. He was very handsome at the time. Yes. Nice big black belt.
Listen, do you think she'd be a good judoka? Just to show that I know, really.
Well, she's got the right hips for her, hasn't she?
Got the hips.
Sexy, I mean.
It's going to be one of those shows. Listen, would you like to have a little demonstration for us?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, let's have a little go. What are you going to show us first?
Well, I think we'll let Hazel show us, shall we?
Yeah.
Shall we show you a bit of self-defence so the girls can learn something?
All right, that's a good idea.
Right, I'm going to cuddle Hazel.
This is a very strange thing. Right! All right! Well, you're not very good, are you? You're supposed to be a champion. What, are you going to show us another one? Do we have time for another one?
Yeah, shall we show you a stomach throw? That's the one where you got right through the air in a big eye.
Oh, heck, this is a funny thing. All right. Well, listen, come on, I must say, it all looks terribly easy to me. I think I might give you a little throw.
Oh, no.
Yeah,
right, I'm ready for you then.
No, I think I might give Hazel.
That's a good idea.
You hold the mic. All right, Hazel.
All right, now I think Al's going to throw Hazel here now. And it looks a bit unfair because Al's a bit bigger than Hazel. What? Hazel's got her! Oh, he's got her! My goodness!
Now, while Hazel...